Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Nampa, Idaho, Northwest Nazarene University in Orion Hills Center Court, home of your Lady Nighthawks. Brent Peterson will be joining us soon, probably around tip-off. Just wanted to welcome you back tonight. And the ladies will be taking on Point Loma Nazarene University, who has a season record of 1-4. And the Lady Nighthawks last night ended up with a great win. Not ended up, they had a great win last night, 70-48 over Concordia. Some highlights from that game last night. Jordy Pinson dropped 16 points. She was 2-for-4 from three-point range. McKenna Castledine ended up with 14 points. Cammie Kanishka, 11 points. And Cammie was 3-of-5 from three-point range. And a great surprise for Coach Steve Steele, Loy Wade, a newcomer, had her best night of the season so far, had 9 points. She was 4-of-6 from the floor. And we look forward to a great game this evening. Point Loma had a great win on Friday against Simon Fraser, 68-64. But tonight, we'll see if the aggressive Steve Steele defense will stay up after last night's fantastic showing last night of the defense turnovers. We will come back to you after the invocation and the playing of the national anthem. Look forward to another great game by your Lady Nighthawks. We'll be with you in just a few minutes. Well, Brent, good to be back with you this evening. Getting ready for tip-off against Point Loma Nazarene University. Had a great showing last night, Nighthawks did. And look forward to another aggressive, hard, fast defensive game. Hopefully we keep their number one player so far is Carrion, who had 31 points against Simon Fraser on Friday night. So we'll see what the Nighthawks can do on defense. And they come out with a tip-off. Castledine at top to Jordy. Nice little spin in the left-handed move.
Yeah, tough shot there. Just kind of forced it a little bit. Good hustle rebound there. They called a foul, I think, down the floor there. Again, yeah, white on foul on three there. That's a tough call. McKenna again on the floor. Castledine. Great hustle as always. Provides his first year. So fun to play the Point Loma Nazarene Sea Lions. So I think their first win yesterday. Is that right? Is that Simon Fraser?
Yes,
is that right?
They did.
Yeah.
They're 1-4 on the season.
Yeah, still early in the season, kind of figuring things out. Yeah, you mentioned number 10 is just their dominant player yesterday, 31 points.
Two early fouls. Again, the Nighthawks are aggressive to the basket. We saw that last night, Brent.
Yeah, we did. And early on, we didn't capitalize on that. We drove a lot, didn't score, but later on in the game, we really penetrated under control, got a lot of layups, and that helped a really strong shooting percentage in the first half. They cooled down in the second half last night. But again, a good victory overall.
That foul on number 10, Allie Carrion. Again, their leading scorer during this tournament, so.
Yeah, 31 points. You've got to be on fire to hit 31 at any level. So, obviously, a lot going on there, and we'll watch her. I'll pick up one quick foul there. And Nighthawks coming into a man-to-man press, full-court press. Into that trap again like last night. Lions break out of it pretty easily. Oh, nice picking there by McKenna. Come on, fast hands, McKenna. Oh, that was a travel.
Yep.
Yeah, and they called it.
Yeah.
She had that. Her dad doesn't like it, but that was a travel all day. She had a nice spin move, but that pivot foot is dragged along the way. That was a travel all day long. But nice move nonetheless. Great hands, though. Great steal. She'll get another chance again tonight for sure.
Oh, she'll get more than one chance tonight.
And again, I'm most impressed. Her shooting's been great, but just her great hands this year. Just so aggressive, and but yet never getting a call for a foul. That's a nice spin move by 25. Nice spin move there by number 25, Haley Sauret from San Bernardino, California. She's a freshman guard this year. Sorry, forward graduate student this year, excuse me. One of the things we have still in the NCAA with COVID, there's some of these players are still having extra COVID years, so some of these players, and obviously we don't know from team to team how that has worked, but some of these kids who want an extra year playing this year because the COVID kind of messed things up.
Sauret, second shot, no good. Kaniska with the rebound. Quickly up to Clark, pushing the ball. Gets her own rebound.
Yeah, Emma Clark's absolutely a piston, just going all the time. Great, and Jordan usually sees her on that outlet there. Had a step on her, but the defender caught up and blocked the first shot. She got it back and put it back up and got a foul. And three quick fouls in the first probably minute here.
Yeah.
So, again, in this setting, five fouls, you hit the free throw line, so we'll want to watch that.
Clark makes her first, ending you 2-1 at the 8:48 mark.
I think the men played Point Loma in their place about a month ago, and I think the Sea Lions defeated the Nighthawks down there, the men's team.
Clark, 2-for-2.
Nice job by Clark there.
Castledine cuts off the
Seawolves.
Oh, great. Kaniska with the ball.
2-on-2.
Great pass.
Nice job by Emma to take that charge.
Castledine with a shot and a roll.
Well, that was a little bit of a wild shot. Now, if she's going to keep shooting those and making them, that'll keep doing it, right? I mean, so a little bit wild there. She's kind of off balance, but that did a nice soft touch. And you get the nice roll there, so good for her. Those balls go in, keep shooting them.
Nice cross court
them up.
Over to Sauret, far corner. To Carrion at the top, back over to Sauret. Driving down low.
Nice defense.
Good,
again.
Great defense.
There she is. First bucket so far. Again, she's just been averaging on the season just 10 points a game, which is great. But the 31 was obviously a breakout game for her, so we'll see. Nighthawks definitely have her in mind to shut her down. Nice extra pass to Emma from the men's line. Oh, didn't go. Great. Love that shot, though. Getting rhythm. That was a great ball movement there by Jordan. Oh, great hands again,
great,
I think,
hands
by
again.
Cammy or McKenna. I'm not sure which one. Again, bothering those passing lanes.
Great defense by Kaniska, shutting down the drive. Over to Sauret, who drives the lane, kicks back out. There's that defense again.
And Cammy, oh, man, what an unfortunate break. Cammy had it again, just the ball didn't bounce that way, and the Sea Lions got a break there. Up to the early 6-5 lead.
Jordy down low to Wade. Loy gets a start this evening.
Well, Loy played phenomenal last night. Just
there's
so good
another rebound for Loy.
Yep, great rebounding and great points, the block. Solid play last night.
Jordy sets it back up, back down to Kaniska.
Oh, it's a great play by number 25 there to poke that out by the Sea Lions. Great hustle on the floor. Boy, great hustle there by the Sea Lions to pop that up. One-on-one break. Good D by Jordan.
Euro step.
Oh, man. Didn't follow up there. Early on, a little extra energy by the sea lines. McKenna's racing down, has a line of the, oh. Boy, could have called a foul there in the back. Well, that could have been
a push in the back.
Yeah.
That's when maybe stop, let the person run into you, go up.
Yeah, she was going so fast. I think stopping was not going to be an option.
Turk up top with a bad pass down low.
As McKenna again poked that away.
Loy Wade on the break. Stop.
Nice job.
There it is.
There it is right there. So, again, she stopped there, jump stop. They kind of, Top Gun, they fly right by, and then you knock it in.
Sounded like Top Gun.
Yeah, exactly what Top Gun. Hit the brakes, they fly right by. Maverick, great movie. Did you see that again this year?
I have.
Woo, man, for all those old people in the 80s who saw it the first time, what a fun movie. Tom Hanks wanted to keep it in the theater, so he said, wait for 2 years, and we'll get it out there and everyone come back and see it. So. But a great play by Lloyd. Lloyd had a great game last night.
She did 9 points last night.
Yeah, just so solid, though. A great rebound, a great presence in the middle, and great shooting, too. So just a really not surprised at all she had to start tonight. Boy, again. And, boy, one of the things the Nighthawks do is everything is contested. Inbounds plays, passes, everything you got to fight for. That's a travel there on the hip.
That's carry. There it is, the defense by Shaughnessy Davis.
Oh, man.
There's our girl.
Shaughnessy, spark plug, lots of energy. Love her in there.
Kanishka
there
on the drive. And Claire Eubanks, who just came in.
And Shaughnessy gets set. Oh.
Follow your shot.
You got to follow your shot. We got a 3-on-1 here with Jordan back.
Left-handed shot, no good by the sea. And a putback by number 45, Annika Thayer. 10-7.
Yeah, in some regard, I think the sea lines are beating the Nighthawks their own game in the fast break. They just got to not getting back as well. And usually that's a rare issue for a Steve Steele team. Still early in the game.
Nice kick out. Jordy drives the floater.
Yeah, that was good there. She also had Claire open the block there. But again, I like what she shoots. Sometimes she overpasses, and that was a great shot. So Claire was open on the block, but got the foul there. But sometimes I think she overpasses occasionally. So
getting ready to check in for your Nighthawks. Annalyn Bonner coming in for Kanishka. Jordy at the line. Shooting two.
Again, we're at four fouls for the Sea Lions. Nice job there making those free throws. Oh, getting back again. Wow. Got a break there. Boy, I have not seen a Steve Teal team getting outraced to the defensive end very often. So it could be the Sea Lions. Part of their game is push that ball, which makes for a fast track option.
Transition
there.
Points, you bet.
Exactly. We usually Nighthawks dominate that and always getting back, but Sea Lions so far very
Shaughnessy
good. Oh, Shaughnessy crossover.
Crossover, crossover.
Great defense, though, by number 10. One of their best players.
That's
again.
Carry on.
Man, she's on both ends of the court, sounds like. Well, hard-fought game early on. First 9-10, Sea Lions are leading us. We'll go to immediate timeout.
Immediate timeout. We'll see you right after break. Well, just checking the ESPN scores. Congratulations to the Oregon State Beavers. 38-34 win over the in-state rivalry.
Hey, by the way, this is a Nazarene College game here. I believe Justin Smith goes to Nazarene Church, the head coach of the Oregon State Beavers. So I think he attended first at PASNAZ down in California. He was at USC, I think.
Okay.
Good friends of my pastor, Scott Daniels. I believe that's right. Inside there by Jordan Pinson. inside drive by DeShaughnessy. Oh.
Oh, she got her own rebound. I thought she got a rebound. There it is. Jump ball.
All right.
Yeah.
She followed her shot, got a rebound there. Again, Sea Lions are a good team. They're only 1-4 in the season. Actually, the first win last night, but boy, coming out strong already. And it could be they just played some really dominant opponents early on. So early season's record is really hard to gauge the quality of a team based on who they played.
There's the break.
Boy, again, they're pushing that ball. In this young season, I think they've done the best pushing the ball against us thus far. Usually we're always back in the faster team, but tonight they're pushing it hard.
Carry on with a dribble near side. Quick pass down low. They're looking to cross court.
Well, good job by Shaughnessy there. Well, that was phenomenal defense there by the Nighthawks. Again, just bothering them. A stalwart of their play is just bothering their passes and then being able to control the entire defensive end there. So, again, a great defensive stop by the Nighthawks causing a 30-second chalk violation. And then we have Castledine passing in to Jordan.
A little mini full-court press.
Yeah, just picking her up.
Disruptor.
Picking her up.
Jordy with the left-hand dribble and the floater.
That's so good.
Man, that's so sweet.
Boy, I really feel like this might be one of her best seasons of freshman year. Her confidence the last several games is just so strong.
Cross court by the Sea Lions to 13. Mersch.
That is
a turnover.
That defensive play again. The pressure, the trap caused that throwing away. Again, stalwart is causing turnovers. While the Lions are getting a little back faster than we are, I'm sure, again, we're already causing more turnovers. And that's, again, a stalwart for. You know, I still think our defense absolutely is the fuel of our offense. As we are pushing and causing turnovers.
And it disrupts their flow, their game flow, in setting up points. There's a tough foul. No call.
Nice steal there by number 45.
Travel, but no call.
Annika Thayer. Whoa, that was almost in there.
Jordy with the rebound. The pace has picked up a little bit here.
Yeah, both teams are pushing the ball hard up the court, which we'll see who has the stamina. I mentioned last night we felt like the Nighthawks had a little better shape than the other team.
But Davis out to Clark, back to Jordy.
So far, Sea Lions step for step. Oh, Jordan, the great buck there.
There's the stop and pop.
Oh, there
and
it
the
is.
Foul.
Boy, that confidence there for her to get that space. Her crossover is so good. And that floater was falling last night and falling tonight so far. Man, it's a lethal shot because she's not going to get out of town, but she'll stop and pop that shot.
Well, you figure she, you know, the defense, all right, let's settle back in, not let her drive. Then she stops and has, what, about a 3-foot separation between
her and
the
defender. Yeah, because she's so quick. She's beating her opponent off the dribble, and she can go left and right. And, again, these kind of soft little pop shot there, but elbows have been just falling real well tonight. Just so pure, too.
With 2 minutes and 52 seconds left in the first period, Nighthawks will be shooting double bonus.
Got a little shooter's roll there, a little 4-iron make. But Jordan is clearly the leader of this team. Great. I mean, Cammy as well, but you can just tell, and obviously get her breather in here, but Jordan absence sets the tone for the entire Nighthawks offense and defense. Cammy's got to be careful there. She's lucky they didn't call it. Yeah, boy.
Wow. Again.
Cammy got away with them there. I thought she was kind of blocking all the way
little
down the
body.
Court. Body all the way down. They didn't call. Last night they were calling a couple times.
Bobadilla brought the ball up all the way to their basket and threw up kind of a wild shot, but I think Cammy
Cammy even fouled her on that shot, too. That play is just, I think Cammy got a couple breaks there, to be honest. But he loved the aggressiveness. Sometimes the refs are calling, sometimes they're not.
Castledine on the far side. Cross court to Kanishka with 3. No good. Castledine
nice.
With a great rebound. Kick
nice
back
job.
Out to Kanishka.
Castledine so smart there. Could have gone for a 4 shot, but didn't. That was a
no.
flop.
Oh,
that was inside.
A flop.
That was inside the. I don't know how they call that. That was inside the circle. Yeah, I don't know the rule there, but she was definitely underneath the hoop.
Steve's asking for some clarification underneath.
Yeah, that one felt like totally inside the hoop, which would not be a charge. Yeah, nothing to no avail.
He gives a thumbs up, but for what?
Yeah, that was a miss there because she was definitely inside the restricted area. Oh, well, that happens.
Yep.
You get some and lose some, and that's all right. 14-10 with 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Fun, energetic game so far. Both teams playing very hard.
Good hands, quick on the switch. Back over to Turk, no good. They're going to call McKenna on a foul.
Yeah.
Nope.
Oh, yeah, I think they are. Yeah, that's a good call. They're both going for the ball. I think number 45, Annika Thayer, was there a beat ahead, and so therefore got the call against Castledine.
Loy Wade checking back in for United Hawks, replacing Eubanks.
Yeah, really, Loy and Eubanks playing so well together. It was interchangeable, and so getting some breath and some good minutes by both of them this juncture. Trying to sub in number 3, Kylie Hearn. From Phoenix, Arizona, and Scottsdale Christian. I know it well. I grew up in the Phoenix area.
I did not know that.
I did. I've been all over. I almost went to Point Loma, my man. I was there a lot of times. Great campus, beautiful campus, great professors, great student body, fabulous school. So proud to have them part of our connection network, Nazarene Schools in Western Canada. Nice jumper there.
No good.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Oh, that was pretty.
Reverse shot by Surratt.
Yeah, that was pretty. Right now, I think the sight line is a little more aggressive. They're playing a little stronger.
Castledine in the drive.
Wow,
and
that was pretty.
A kiss off the glass.
I would have loved a left-handed layup there, but she hit it right hand and kind of with an inside scoop and went it in. But nice first step to beat her opponent. Nice response there.
Point Loma setting it up with Bodie at the top. Back to Thayer. Setting a screen and a pick and roll.
Yeah.
Nice, and a block by there. Loy Wade.
Yeah, nice recovery there. Nice pick and roll and great pass in, but Loy recovered for the block.
Under 1 minute to play in the first quarter. You score Nighthawks 16, Point Loma 12.
It was stunning last night. Our first quarter, we had 30 points in the first quarter last night.
That
was ridiculous. Like 4 threes. We go again.
Kick back out.
That was off the travel. Oh, nice pick there by that Emma. Wow, the travel.
Oh, Carrie.
Yeah,
Carrie.
Put on the hip there. Now, the last night, we had one in the men's game. We had one on the shoulder, didn't call. But that was an easy
against
call.
Against Azusa last night.
She wanted to do a stutter step there, but she just trapped it on her hip. So she can do it with her hands. But when you put it against your body, they're going to call
the
that.
Trap.
Oh, nice break there. Way to see that. Nice D again. Boy, Steve Steele's wanting some travels on their first moves by some of the Lions, Sea Lions players.
Hearn at the top. Over to Turk. Turk stopped your dribble. Gets trapped on the far sideline.
Again, real tough D there. Oh, nice job. Good job, Emma Clark.
That's great.
Again, bottomed that pass. Bottomed that pass and caused to go off the hands of number 25.
23 seconds left.
I go for a last shot here, I would think. Up 16 to 12.
Konishka and Jordy Pence with 19 seconds left. Jordy getting ready to set up the play. Got Loy Wade at the top, getting ready to set the screen.
Boy.
Over to Clark.
Oh,
no
boy,
good.
Great shot.
And at the end of one, your score, Nighthawks 16. Point Loma 12 will be right back after the break. Well, back at the break, one of the stats, Brent, that we wanted to take a look at was three-point shooting. Right now, Point Loma is 1-for-3, 33%, and Nighthawks, in comparison to last night, we were 0-for-5.
Yeah, so that's not good.
That's
last night, I think we were like 60% in that first half, first quarter. And like I said, you win and die by that. But again, taking good shots. I don't feel like, there we go, Cammy again launching
Speaking
away.
Speaking of the three-point shot.
Well, he could call it over the back, there easily. But again, I think we're taking good shots. And, you know, basketball is like that. You're going to be hot some nights, cold the next. I'd say your shooter is going to shoot as long as taking good shots. And I think that the threes that we had, almost all of them have been wide-open threes. And so
no contested shot on the three-point.
Yeah,
point.
And so they're not forcing it. So, again, right. And they'll fall. I mean, like last night, you get a little lucky. Some of them being dropping in, and tonight, a little rough start. But
it's
nice
a great
move by
Shaughnessy.
Oh, man. Boy, what we've seen so far this year is her first step has always been quick, but her finish now, so under control.
Mersh back to Carrion, who drives.
Boy, nice move there, Carrion. She's a player. And we mentioned yesterday, 31 points against Simon Frazier. I think she has probably, I think, 7 so far tonight, if there are 8 or 9.
There's
not
a
sure.
quick move.
That's a good recovery there.
Man, I tell you, Shaughnessy's first move, that first step is so great.
And then what we've seen even this year, just her ability to finish would be there. Again, she's finishing the inside hand. I do that left-handed layup there. You can protect the body and... It's harder than to block you because you have to almost have to foul you. But you give them that inside hand, your right hand on the left side. That's a foul there too, probably.
Down to Loy Wade. Hand off to Kanishka. Up and in. Kanishka gets her own rebound.
Yeah.
Jump ball. Possession goes to the Seawolves. 18-14. Starting of your second period. Inbound to Carrion. Quickly down. Kanishka cuts off. Forces a bad shot. Back to Jordy Pinson, who brings the ball up.
I will say tonight, even though they've beaten us in the break, we have bothered them on their shots.
There's converted. That first step. That's a block. There
yeah,
it is.
Again, because she's inside that, oh man, hard fall though. She's inside the restricted area.
Maddie Mersh took one hard there.
I don't know the rule, Rob, to be honest with you. Can you kind of call any charges inside the restricted area? What's the rule on that? I mean, I'm pretty sure that's why they have that.
Right.
Because the danger is you can't have a player who sets up down there, because it's dangerous for both these players. That's why they don't want to encourage folks to be underneath the hoop.
Correct.
Because basically what they're saying is you can launch and land inside that lane and be okay, but if they set up underneath there, then you could just get charged the whole day.
Yeah, because you're so close to the basket, too. Yeah. Then you're elevated by the time you get to that point.
And again, Shaughnessy coming in hard there. I think got a knee or foot. Maybe it landed on her.
I think it was
her.
A knee.
Yeah.
In the rib cage.
To be honest with you, that felt like the first one we had. We called that foul called on McKenna. They're going to review this here. Again, I want to review the other one, too. And I think now for the women, obviously, if you can see it on TV, that white line internally, the white line is the one, and inside there, that is where the women are, and the black is the men's.
Yeah, we'll have to clarify that with Coach Steele.
Yeah.
Because that's happened a couple times so far this year, so.
Well, again, tonight, what's confusing was that earlier, and I think it was on McKenna they called it on. I was almost positive that the C-line player was inside, and they called a charge. So, in my mind, I was thinking that you cannot have a charge be called in that line. And clearly that one, in my mind, I'm going to review it right now, was also in that area as well.
We were looking for the replay, but understandable that we won't show the replay if someone does get injured on the play. So just a clarification. Officials are still deliberating over what the call will be.
I'm guessing that's the decision point there as to was she in a restricted area or not. I don't know if it's going to be a block or a charge. And again, similar to that one, it felt like she was inside the restricted area. So we'll clarify that. Hopefully the refs will come and get an explanation at the table, which will be the coach's explanation. We'll kind of ease in. And
Tim Milburn, our PA announcer, hopefully will let the fans know. We can let you all know as well.
And here we go. Oh, coaches are coming together. We'll try to eavesdrop here. Oh, give them the word to Tim.
Okay, so it was a personal foul on the Sea Lions player. And both coaches are understanding that.
Kind of hugging it out there, yeah, a little bit. I think what I saw from the Sea Lions coach is she saw there was a knee up in the air, which is true. Now, my bias comes in because my entire basketball game was my knee was in the air coming at you. So,
well, you jumped so high, though.
I did jump pretty high, actually, for a small white guy. I dunked every now and then, by the way.
Well, back in the day, I had a couple myself.
That's right.
But that was many years ago.
I think the height was 9 feet in those days.
Maybe 8.5.
Yeah.
All right, at the line for your Nighthawks, Shaughnessy Davis be shooting 2.
Again, I think the coaches want to know, and you know, I think she was in charge, but I think the knee in the air, but that can be a flagrant foul if you call a kick. You know, you kind of kick or extend it inappropriately, and I think their coach is asking for that. I think that was not the case. But you can be called for that by an inadvertent leg going wrong, you know, not just for a basketball move.
Shaughnessy was 1-for-2, 19-14 at the 8:49
mark. Full court press here, almost 5 count there. Oh, nice break. We got 2-on-1 here.
There's carry on.
Boy, they got to wait. Yeah, Shaughnessy totally pushed on that. I was going to wonder when they – Rob and I have a new theory that when the balls go up, if the ball doesn't go in, they're probably going to call a foul. But they're waiting. That was a case there where Shaughnessy fouled way in advance, and they waited until after the ball didn't go in to call it. Now maybe the ref's just kind of watching the whole play, but – yeah, I think we don't want to foul her.
No.
Yeah, whenever you have a great score, they're often foul great shooters, so Allie Carrion is going to be someone to keep away from the line. Boy, what a pretty shot.
Nothing but the bottom of the net on both those. Here's a quick ball up. Should be a block on number 24, Shayla O'Neill. That's 2 quick fouls. Kanishka getting ready to inbound the ball to Pinson. Pinson setting things up. Back to Kanishka. Jordy at the top. Over to Lloyd Wade. To Davis. Back to Jordy at the top.
Well, with man-to-man, an interesting offensive scheme here. All 4 players at the top of the key are outside the 3-point stripe. Probably looking to penetrate, I'm guessing.
Kanishka sets up for 3 and buries it from the elbow.
She had 2 or 3 last night. It might be our first one tonight, I think. Well, I'm not sure.
It is.
We're 1-for-7, I believe, or something like that. So, again, but a good shooter's got to shoot. We want her to keep shooting that ball, and they'll eventually fall.
Long cross-court pass over to Carrion. Nope. Excuse me.
Oh.
That was number 24, Shayla O'Neill. That was in and out. Jordy Pinson gets the ball under Loy Wade.
Again, just a lazy pass.
Deep pass for the Seawolves. Good help by Loy underneath.
Loy again,
shut her down.
Shut it down there.
Carry on him at the top.
Ah, yep, a good foul. Nice drive to the hole by number 12.
Madison Corder. Madison will be at the line shooting 2. Checking back in for Loy Wade would be Claire Eubanks. 22-16 at 7:33 mark.
Madison, also a grad student. We don't know if it's a fifth-year senior or fifth-year grad or if COVID helped that. But probably someone with lots of experience in their program, you'd imagine.
Clark and Castle are getting ready to check back in for your Nighthawks. And they'll have to wait for a moment. Kanishka up to Pinson, who brings the ball up to the left side, near side here. Back to Clark. Brings it back and around.
That was close.
Stuck her foot in the ground and held herself.
It was close.
Shaughnessy Davis down low to Kanishka.
And shot clock getting down to 5-4-3. They got to make a move here. Claire's got to shoot that ball.
And no call. Seawolves bring the ball up and turn the ball over.
Yeah, again, a really awkward pass. It kind of bounced through the Seawolves player's legs.
Kanishka over to Clark, who dribbles around to the top of the key. Down low.
Oh, that could have a foul there, boy.
They're harassing Claire underneath. Dribbles back out. Great. Move and pass. Clark on the rebound.
All right, nice cat Clark there.
All right, Jordan will set things up with 16 on the shot clock. Back to Clark. Over to Shaughnessy with a drive.
Yeah. Yeah, number 12 on the Sea Lions, Madison Quarter, got that call, and she had several fouls on that exchange. They just called the last one there.
Three quick fouls at 6:21. Nighthawks up 22-17. Jordan Pence will inbound the ball underneath their own basket.
And last night we struggled on the inbounds play. Tonight a little better.
Clark back to Pence on the far side. Will stop and pop. It's a little short. Yeah. I think the ball got tipped a little bit.
I think it did. I think it did get tipped a little bit. See McKenna's trying to pop that ball out. One of McKenna's tricks is to come from behind and pop you up there, but just missed there.
Turk with the ball at the top of the key, getting ready to set a screen on McKenna. The switch.
Oh, nice hands by McKenna
there it
again. Swiped that ball loose. McKenna's open on the wing here. Jordan in the middle. Didn't see her. Kat Clark, top of the key. Claire wants it, begging for the block. Double teamed.
Back out to Clark with a stop and pop. There it is.
Boy, that was pretty too.
Yeah.
Man, the last couple of nights, we had open jumpers there inside the key.
About 12-foot, maybe 13-foot
nice,
shot.
Solid
you
shot.
Bet. Turk bringing the ball up. Almost a steal by Clark. Carry on with the ball. Back at the top to Turk. Clark covering her.
But I think 24-17 might be the biggest lead of the game, I think, Rob. I'm not sure.
I think you're right, Brent.
But again, both teams playing really hard.
Turk with the left hand, dribbles over the far side. Baseline drive.
Yeah, that was due to Claire Eubanks just closing that, sealing that baseline off.
There's some travel.
Yeah. That worked out okay. Could have called a jump ball, but really she kind of stumbled on her feet and went down. That is a travel.
Haley Surratt was going for the dribble and drive and got a little.
Yeah, she kind of tripped on her own feet and went down. They'll call the travel. They could have. Yeah. Could have been a jump. Could have called a foul on the Nighthawks, but turned out well for the Nighthawks.
Kanishka back over to Clark. Gets it across the half-court line. McKenna with a stop and pop the glass.
Come on.
Little kiss off the glass.
I have so loved her game.
Timeout. The coach was all the way on the GNAC logo on the court.
I think she really wanted a timeout, and she got one.
I think so. She got one. We'll be right back after the timeout. Your Nighthawks are up 26-17 at 4:51 in the second period. Back after the timeout, Seawolves will be taking the ball in underneath their own basket. Brent, you were asking about turnovers. The Seawolves have committed 11 turnovers. And that's due to that, again, tenacious defense, like right there.
Oh, yeah, they're going to get a call there. That was close. I think they actually called it after the ball was out there, preventing everyone to get the ball.
Checking in for your Nighthawks, Ellie Friend, number 30.
Going out, Claire Eubanks coming out.
Give her a little break.
I didn't notice the Sea Lions are up just a slight 16-13 on a rebound total.
Backdoor.
Nice backdoor there, boy. Didn't feel the layup.
To Mersh. Mersh back over to Turk. 3-point shot up. No good. Oh. Boy, Emma Clark is so quick. Undercut. Yeah.
Guy went after a shin, but good hustle there. Well, a good game so far. Right now, 26-17 advantage. Both teams playing really hard. Inbound play here by the Sea Lions. Oh, nice backdoor. What a play. Yeah. Backdoor, great pass and great finish there.
By Turk.
By number one, Ellie Turk, yeah, from San Diego via Foothills Christian.
Clark over to Kanishka, far side.
Like that shot. Oh, like that a lot.
Oh, look at there. Thank you very much.
Sometimes it'd be the right place, the right time, and just popped it back in.
Listen.
Clark on the layup there.
On the stat sheet, that'll look like a rebound and a putback.
That's right. Sometimes the ball just comes to you. Trap there, half court. Again, look at that nice play by Kat Clark. picking up after the bad pass from the trap that caused the problem. Oh, Cammie, shoot that ball.
Cammie thought about it. She was out about 30.
Take a dribble then. She was wide open. No C-line within 15 feet of her. But probably the wiser of the wise decided to bring it in.
Ellie Friend back to Kanishka on the drive.
Oh, nice move. Oh, it's a good drive there. Used her body to shield off the player. Just couldn't
Kanishka
finish
just
there.
Tipped the ball.
The danger with that is often players, when they play and miss a shot, they're kind of over-aggressive and get a foul there. But again, Cammie's under control. Nice move, wheel route again. That's two in a row. They had a wheel route on the inbound play, and then right there, another wheel route to get another layup. So cutting into that lead in here. Now 28-21 are the Nighthawks with 3:15 in the second quarter. Excuse
Clark
me.
With the three, no good. Ellie Friend underneath for the rebound.
Nice job, Ellie.
Back up to Clark.
Oh, man.
Rebound by her sister, Clark.
On,
back
Cammie.
To Kanishka. No good.
Oh, good hustle there by the Nighthawks. I think three or four offensive rebounds there. You know what? Keep shooting the ball. I love it. They were wide open. They weren't forced. You know, I'm not sure if Coach Steele is happy with that, but, man, you watch them play. They're good open looks, and they're going to fall. You love the offensive rebounds from their shot. We didn't get a shot made there, but look at that.
Clark with the
boy, Cat Clark. I mean, excuse me, Emma Clark in that time, excuse me. Great hands. That's a travel.
Travel. There we go.
There it is.
Again, help defense.
Yep.
Settle down, and
yep.
Castledine came over to help. Another turnover.
Yeah, fast hands, fast feet, and we just are absolutely can cause havoc. Although, Niners need somebody to pass that ball in. Right now, none of my Jordan's on the sideline here.
28-21, 2:26 left in the second period.
Emma comes and rescues her. Get the ball back to Jordy.
Jordan crossed half court over to Clark.
Not a big basketball. Not much scoring the last couple of minutes there. We'll see if Nighthawks can break this 28-21 deadlock score. Shot clock at 8 seconds. Yeah. Got a foul there. Will not be shooting yet. It's the fourth foul by the Sea Lions in this quarter.
2:02 left in the second period, 28-21. Nighthawks will take the ball out on the near side. Clark to Pinson.
As we noted, when there's a foul, the shot clock sets to 20 seconds.
Jordan with a stop and pop, no good. Yeah. A little short.
Yeah, two from that side, a little short over there. I like a shot she's taken. Those last two felt a little bit just rushed, but and she does a little better when she's not guarded, you know, come off that a screen or a pass. To shoot that off the dribble isn't her favorite if she knows she's open, wide open.
Clark on carry on, back up top to Mersch. Back to carry on. Over to O'Neal, down low to 45. Thayer, who missed a shot. Davis with a crossover.
Nice defense by 24.
Spin and
yeah.
Up. Nope.
That was ill-advised. Yeah, you love the move there. Great crossover. But that was where you mentioned earlier that finishes are not good for Shaughnessy.
Jordy Pinson on the rebound. Going to hold things up a little bit.
Again, 28-21. Both teams have been stuck here for a little bit. Stay under control. Run your set offense. Half-court offense.
Steve's asking for his team to move a little bit.
1 minute.
1 minute to play in the half.
That was almost a travel by Jordan.
Back to Shaughnessy Davis for three. No good. Rebound Clark. Another 20 seconds for your Nighthawks.
Again, offensive rebounds last have been really helpful. The shots haven't fallen, but give yourself extra chances to go. I think Steve's won the... All right, 9 seconds left. I think Jordan's going to be a Jordan special here. He's going to set up a screen.
Back over to Clark, who's got to stop. Yep,
yeah.
Travel.
Yeah, that didn't look good. Jordan was not, last 10 seconds, nothing looked right about that set there. If they wanted to go that to that side, they got to go a lot earlier.
28 seconds left. Sea Lions inbound the ball. Clark with some tough defense, bringing the ball up. Was carry on. Over to Mersch. Mersch to Thayer.
Nice pick by Emma Clark. She has Shaughnessy breaking on 2-on-1.
There's a nice pass.
And the left hand with the foul.
Left hand.
Finish with the left hand. We love it. And then the foul there, again, the finishing by Shaughnessy, and that last shot was out of control and wild. Again, her finish has been a lot stronger tonight. Broke that 21-28
drought
there. And then hopefully push this to a 10-point. Shaughnessy can hit this one here. And she does. 10-point lead now, 11 seconds to go in the first half.
Hilly Surratt checking back in along with Cammy Konishka. 11.4 seconds left in the first half.
Again, a full court press to eat up some clock here. We'll see if they can. Boy, a great move by Curry. Oh, half court.
Seawolves, 3-point shot, no good. Claire Eubanks got the rebound, but was stripped. At halftime, your score, Nighthawks 31, Point Loma 21. We'll be back after the half. Thanks for joining us here at Northwest Nazarene University. Beautiful day here in Nampa, Idaho. We'll see you after the half. before the third period, you just wanted to look at a few stats. So far for the Nighthawks, we've got, or excuse me, for Point Loma, we have Carrion, who has 9 points. Surratt has 5 points, the two leading scorers. Again, Carrion, who scored 31 points the other night against Simon Fraser. And for Northwest Nazarene University, we've got Jordy Pinson, who has 7 points. McKenna Castleline also has 7 points. The two leaders for each one of the teams. And shooting percentages are not the best tonight. Northwest Nazarene University is sitting at 32%. Point Loma is at 33%. The one bright spot is NNU at the charity stripe is at 80%. Point Loma at 66.7%. And again, the rebounding, we're doing well in rebounding. NNU is 22 total rebounds with 12 offensive rebounds and 10 defensive boards, where Point Loma has 18 total rebounds, 11 defensive rebounds, and 7 offensive rebounds. So
felt like in the last 2 or 3 minutes, we had a possession where we had 3 or 4 offensive rebounds at one time. I'm not sure we made any of the shots eventually, but you're liking those rebounds and these extra shots. That's the one advantage in three-pointers is you can get longer rebounds. And so, but again, both teams playing hard here. It doesn't feel like a 10-point difference, but we'll see what the teams come back. And a lot of energy by the Lions early on, down running the court. But we'll see what happens going forward. I was curious, and they came out of the locker room. Sea Lions went into a layup drill, and you wonder if the coach wanted to emphasize something there. Typically, I don't know if that's part of their regular program, but curious little move coming out of the break. But we'll see what happens.
Getting ready to start the third period. Pure score 31-21. Nighthawks are up. And Nighthawks will inbound the ball first. Should be a great second half. We'll see if we can continue the aggressive defense that a Steve Steele team does create. Looks like Point Loma's coming out with some aggressive defense.
Oh, it was a quick turnover there.
They'll put it back at half court. Castledine getting to inbound the ball to Loy Wade. Loy Wade with a short dribble back to Castledine. Oh, out of bounds.
I just didn't start well. When I first got that hand on that first pass, that boy, Punt Loma, was ready to go, and there is couldn't get away from that sideline, and McKenna ended up dribbling out of bounds.
Yeah,
there,
Shayla so. O'Neill with the defense on McKenna. Carry on bringing the ball up court.
Nice hands again by McKenna. Look at that steal.
Jordy controls the ball.
Not only does McKenna get that poke away, that steal, but she get that quick speed to get there. She's long enough to get there quickly to get a position on another player.
There's a nice back door.
There it is.
Kanishka to nice Loy Wade.
Nice feed from Cammy. And nice run by
Loy Wade, yeah.
Running the hole there and running that little wheel route.
Boy, McKenna almost got another steal on the inbound.
Boy, she gets so long and so.
There's the steal. Back to Kanishka. Up and in.
There it
off
is.
The glass.
Some key points off of this pressure here.
Carry on bringing the ball up on the far side. Over to Turk. Back to Hearn.
Oh, nice move there. Back
underneath.
To by Carry. Nice pass, number 3. Kyler Hearn. To carry on there, nice back door.
Stepped out of bounds.
Really? Okay.
35-23, 8:48 left in the third period. Nighthawks with a turnover.
We had about a 3-minute stint in the last part of that second quarter. No one can score. And again, this one, we've come out scoring quick. I think already about 8 points scored in this half so far.
I think they got Loy Wade on a block out.
Yeah, I think they're pushing there or shoving.
It's okay. I like the aggressive defense. Establishing herself underneath the basket, not letting a
challenge,
easy.
Challenge,
yeah.
Loy's got her third now, so she's ought to come out. So Eubanks is in. So you like the aggressive. She's got to play smart, though. Again, I didn't see what happened there. But you're right. You want to be aggressive, establish yourself. You got to pay attention to your fouls, too.
inbound by Carry On. Another forced turnover, just off the outreached hands of Eubanks.
Yeah, and then McKenna diving forward, couldn't quite reach it. Again, good aggressive play again. But contesting everything coming in.
Well, that's a deep inbound ball. Another
good defense there.
Great defense by Claire Eubanks. Jordy Pinson bringing the ball up.
When coaches say hands up, that's why right there. Hands were straight up.
To Clark. Back over to Castledine. Over to Kanishka with a short jumper with a miss.
That shot felt a little bit forced there.
Jordy with a contested shot. A little ping pong ball there. Not sure.
Yeah, it's out on Cammy.
Okay.
You got Kate Clark and Shaughnessy Davis coming in for Emma Clark and for McKenna Castledine.
35-23, 8 minutes left in the third period. Hearn to O'Neill.
Wow, that was pretty.
Quick, nice.
Man, that was a nice jumper there by Hearn. Elbow. I turned around. All confidence in the world has drained that shot. What a confident shot that was. Claire called for it on the block.
Nice left-handed shot.
Just kind of stiffed arm there. A little bit short. A good defensive play there. She just couldn't quite get the extension there. The defender was right on her.
Carry On for three. No. Jordy with the rebound.
Nice aggressiveness. Could have even pulled away. Sea Lions player was going right after. That's a foul.
Yep. Shayla O'Neill and the reach in on Jordy. Jordy had a couple steps on her.
Too fast, and she just got that block or reach, whatever they called there.
O'Neill's second personal, first team foul for the Seawolves. Sea Lions, excuse me. Jordy Pinson down low to Claire.
Yeah, that's two in a row by Claire. Just a little bit out of control. I know she's wanting to get a foul there, but play a little smarter there, I think. She's a little bit kind of exasperated, kind of looking for the monster foul, and they're just not calling it. I think it's a good call. There's no calls there. It's good defense.
Yeah, O'Neill was playing some tough defense on her. O'Neill with a three-point
shot. Drained that, man. Boy.
28-35.
I think that's five in a row for O'Neill, right? She's in that jumper in the corner. A pretty shot. She's a good little shooter. Again, Cammy, good hands there by, boy, looking like the Nighthawks there. Backdoor pass off her shin. Saved it up, number three. A little helter-skelter if the
Hearn up top to Turk. Turk setting up a play.
Sea Lions score here. They can break it to five or four. So, again, nice little run by the Sea Lions here. Try to stop them. Ooh, almost a double
great
dribble.
Help by Jordy Pinson.
It's great D there.
Deep shot by the Sea Lions. Boy, Jordy got that. She was trying to throw it off the Sea Lion player, and Clark got the ball. Coast to coast.
Oh, not enough legs. She had the angle on it there. Just didn't get quite high enough for the wrist. The angle didn't quite come through. Nice move
crossover.
There. Woo, that was pretty. Up and under by number one. All of a sudden, we got a five-point game. Sea Lions fought hard here to come back in this game. We had an 11-point lead at one point in this half. Sea Lions playing hard. Boy.
Boy, that's a tough
25
foul.
25 is just absolutely taking it to
Claire.
Claire there. Finally got a call there, but
Bonna Clark and Castledine checking in for the Nighthawks. Checking in for Point Loma is Annika Thayer. Jordan Pinson getting inbound the ball underneath their own basket.
The Nighthawks here need to kind of stop this little run here.
Out to Castledine, far side. Brings it back up top of the key. Back to Jordy Pinson. To Clark, dribbles left-handed over to Castledine. Bonner down low, another foul.
Well, it felt like to me that
on Surratt.
These last two calls were not nearly as hard as earlier, a couple possessions down. There's maybe some makeup calls. They were fouls, but not nearly as hard as she was getting hit the last two times on the court. So maybe Steve got a word in there or Claire did, say, hey, can you watch it? And you ask politely. Because what tends to happen is a player, you start getting aggressive and not calling that, you're going to keep doing it.
Right.
Until they call you and knock it off. That's how that's going to work. So
into Eubanks.
I think Claire needs to be careful here.
Yep.
Yeah, she just, Claire's forcing a little bit right now. I was worried about that when she had the ball.
That's a
travel.
Yep.
We're out of bounds.
Out of
two.
Bounds. Again, pressed up against the sideline.
Yeah, use that design as your defender, and they absolutely just sealed her off there. Nowhere to go. Either going to be out of bounds or a travel or.
Ellie Friend checking in for Eubanks.
Claire had some good minutes. She needs a little breather there, just kind of get a little frustrated offensively, and so do I give her a breather. Love how hard she plays. Love the aggressiveness, just not converting and forcing a little bit.
Jordy Pinson on the drive and the floater.
That's a tough shot there.
That's a real tough shot. Friend with
nice
the rebound.
Friend. She got
and a reach in.
Oh, man. It's a great rebound there. That was a tough shot by Jordan because she was floating and off the bank. You know, floating those with a bank is just really hard.
Allie carry on with the personal foul. It's four fouls on Point Loma right now. Carry on second personal.
One more for a bonus.
Emma Clark over to Bonner. Got shut down on the drive up top. To Pinson, to Clark on the drive. And stop and pop.
Yeah, those shots are hard. I mean, that's the best one you want there. You're running away from the basket, shooting back across their body. Which of those who are right-handed. Nice job by, again, McKenna messing with that pass.
Carry on with an aggressive pass.
Off the feet. Yeah. That's a little frustration there as well. But that's legal. Better or worse.
Media timeout on the court. 35-30. Nighthawks are still up against Point Loma. We'll be back after that break.
We have the Nighthawks still up with a 5-point lead against Point Loma. Again, they've clawed back. It's been 5 points here. I think maybe a 6-0 run. I'm not exactly sure, but. And with the ball, they can cut in that lead even again. Oh, nice shot.
Shot by Shayla O'Neill underneath the basket.
We're now to a 3-point lead. Sea Lions very much in the next game. That was a travel and a push. Could have called several things there.
Steve's asking for a little help there.
Yeah, well, she also traveled, but she's also pushed, so maybe there's a no call is how you do that.
Kaniska to Friend, over to Bonner. Long three-point shot, no good. Out of bounds, off Castledine. Steve's still asking for a little bit of help. Mersch inbound. To carry on, brings the ball up far side.
Cut her off. What a nice kick outside.
3-point
there
shot.
It is. That's a tie ball game right there.
35-35, 3:55 left in the third period.
And I think that we have led almost all this game until right now. We've been tied since the beginning of 0-0. That was 1-1, I believe. But we're not having most of this game until right now with 3 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Bonner at the top to Key for three. No good. Over the top. No call. Ellie Friend with the rebound back to Kaniska. Kaniska takes the three ball, no good. There's McKenna, aggressive. Oh,
that's a foul.
That is travel.
Boy, they got away
jump
with
ball.
Him there. Bonner absolutely.
Wow.
Bonner absolutely fouled there. They got away with him there, so they'll take that.
There's a lot going on in that short period of time there.
Yeah. All we know is a 35-35, Sea Lions with the ball with a chance to take a lead. So again, kind of an offensive big slump here. I think it's almost 11-0 run, maybe, Rob. The exact stats in front of me. I think it was 35-24.
You're correct. There's a nice cut by Carrion, but McKenna shut her down. Cross court to Turk. Covered by Jordy. Down low.
That's a foul. Yeah. Here we go. Chance to go to the line and take the lead.
Annika Thayer. Got the ball deep underneath the basket. Nighthawks did settle back down underneath, but came away with some heavy hands.
Yeah, and again, right now, the C-line just have all the intensity and making the shots. Offensively, the Nighthawks a little bit out of balance.
Thayer. Missed her first one, getting ready to set for her second shot. Makes her second, 36-35.
First lead from seed lines in a long time. Maybe since early in that first quarter, they even had a lead all day today. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think they did early on, turnover.
Yeah, when it rains, it pours a little right now. Nighthawks will be okay. He's got to calm down. Maybe pressing a little bit here. So they go back to their bread and butter, a full court press, what they love. They feel very at home at that. The keys got the foul and use good footwork.
Turk back to carry on. Nice give and go. A block.
Yeah, that was a little rough there.
Personal foul call on number 22, Lauren Wade, her fourth personal of 2003.
Lloyd Wade's got a check out of the ball game. I think that was a little out of control, but
yeah, I don't like that call, to be honest with you. She hit the ground hard, but I think it was mostly she was out of control more than anything else. So
getting ready to check in for the Sea Lions, Kate Bobadilla, excuse me. Carry on,
nice
inbound.
Job. Emma Clark batted that inbound the hallway.
Boy, there's some tough things happening low with Ellie Friend and Annika Thayer.
They're battling down there, aren't they?
They are.
On those, I'd like to see a no call there. I think both people just getting good position. I don't see anything dramatic, but.
Nighthawks fourth team foul. Thayer on the jumper, no good. Block out, rebound by Clark to Pinson. Back to Clark, over to her sister Clark. There's a reach in foul, number 13.
They are calling this game a little tighter, Rob. I think they've noticed they're getting a lot of control. So the last up and down, they've been calling it a little bit tighter. Probably a concerted effort to get under control a little bit here. Should be at the line, down by a point. Kate Clark from Melba, Idaho, Melba High School. She and her sister are sure key parts of this Nighthawks team.
And we got another sister hopefully coming.
I've heard that.
They have a third sister. Be great to have her.
The Clark trio.
The trio.
If she's anything like her sisters, sign it up, right?
Wow,
come on.
No,
I mean, what you get from the Clarks is absolute intensity, great shot selection, and just hustle, hustle, hustle. Fast hands. They never stop. Never stop. And they're always where the action is. And especially on defense, they're just absolutely a nightmare to have to contend with.
Great athlete. She stepped out of bounds. Official
Didn't
did not see,
it. See
that. Right in front of Steve Steele, who wanted to make the call. Didn't have a whistle.
That's a good point. Give me a whistle. I can make that one up.
Carry on. Left-handed dribble. Back over to Turk. Turk with a three-point ball. No good.
Great offensive rebound by 45. Great cut to the hoop. Boy, again, right now the Sea Lions are just absolutely out-hustling. Got an offensive rebound. And then carry on with a drive to the hoop. Sea Lions are absolutely out-hustling the Nighthawks right now.
38-37, Point Loma. Three-point shot, no good. Long pass down to Sherratt. Oh, that's a... I thought if that was going to be bounced in off of a head, man, goodness gracious. We got to settle down here just a little bit, Brent.
Yeah.
Take advantage of...
That was a good block there.
Just don't seem like we're in sync
now.
Well,
it feels like we're doing a lot of... Oh, that's a nice move. That was a pretty up and under move there. Three-point lead, probably the biggest lead of the night. I think Steve's going to want to... Oh, Steve's going to let it play. Maybe want a timeout here. Well, right now the Sea Lions are absolutely outplaying the Nighthawks in this last, probably this quarter for sure.
Yeah.
And what I see offensively is a lot of just one person creating their own offense. I don't see a lot of team offense right now. I think we need to do some more screens and more more cutting the ball, some block play inside out. Instead
Clark
of one-on-one.
Nine. Far corner to Clark, who brings it back up to the top to Jordy Pinson.
Jordy almost walked there.
Clark at the top.
Oh, man.
That's Clark. A great pass, great shot.
Oh, we got to leak it.
Under
yeah.
1 minute. 39-40, Nighthawks trail by one. Surratt with a ball. Back to carry
there
on.
Go. That is over and back.
She looked a little tired, didn't go for the ball.
Yes, that was
a little winded.
A little winded, exactly right. And carry on has played so well tonight. Just saw that ball, like, yep, nope, I'm not going to get that one.
Nighthawks get it deep in their own zone. See if we can set a couple good screens, get Jordy the ball.
That's
there
good.
It is.
I get a two for one here. You can.
Shaughnessy Davis.
I like seeing Shaughnessy out here. Some energy.
Clark with a great drive.
It's a great steal by number one. She saw it all the way, Ellie Turk.
Turk cut off that pass on the baseline. That's
travel.
A travel, no call. 23 seconds left in the third period. Nighthawks down by one, 40-39. Turk with the ball. Over to quarter. Back to Turk. In and out.
Nice rebound.
Rebound by Bobadilla. Surratt with a shot, no good.
Woo, man.
Wow. There was a lot that happened in the last minute and a half.
It feels like to me, Rob, that we scored four and they scored 16. Is that about right? What was the halftime score?
We'll check that. We'll check that at.
But clearly, Sea Lions dominating this game right now. It's only a one-point game, but Nighthawks need to regroup for a strong fourth quarter.
We'll get back right after the timeout. All right, we're back after the break. Point Loma will be inbounding the ball starting the fourth period.
So again, halftime score was 31-21. So again, Nighthawks score 8 versus 19 by the Sea Lions. So that's all the difference, obviously, in this game. So, but fourth quarter, try to regroup.
My apologies, Nighthawks taking the ball in at the fourth period. Clark at the top, over to Shaughnessy Davis with the drive and the little floater.
Oh,
good.
I love that. A screen play by Ellie Friend there. See a screen out of that play. That's team offense right there. Back to a one-point lead for the Nighthawks to see if they can capitalize on that and stiffen up some D again. As we've always said, they get their energy from their defense. And Sea Lions have absolutely kind of
down
slowed
low.
Down. Oh, nice move.
Yep, and a foul.
Boy, great look there. Great post up there by number
Madison Quarter.
12 Addison Quarter there. Again, she'll do an and one. A great look there. I'm not sure who passed it. Was number one?
Turk, I think, passed the ball
two.
Down.
Yeah, great vision there. And Panola back to a one-point lead. Chance to make that two with this free throw here. I think she's going to make it. I think she will. I think she will.
All right, we're back 43-41, Nighthawks bringing the ball up. Castledine with a drive And that's the baseline.
Again, that's the same play from before, it felt like. You have Friend down there, then clears out of the way and absolutely kind of leaves an open baseline. Now, again, good team offense there. Looked way more fluid. Again, we've scored, again, more points in this first couple minutes we have almost in the half of the last third quarter. Again, tie game 43-43. Both teams playing so
Porter
well.
With the drive.
That's a travel on the hip.
Yep. Got our own rebound. Kicked it back out to Sherratt.
Well, they've got some key offensive rebounds last little bit here.
Another
offensive rebound. Man. Reminds me of the Nighthawks in the second quarter.
Turk with the left hand.
Good block by Shaughnessy. Good
and a steal.
Come on.
Control the ball.
Ooh, that was close by Jordan. She didn't establish herself to get back in.
The official's right on top of that. Clark.
Wow. Kate Clark has some key buckets. One of the few points that scored in the third quarter by Kate. And she had four of our nine, I think.
Sherratt with the ball to Turk. Turk looking to pass back door. Got trapped down below. There's Ellie Friend, jump ball.
It'll be Nighthawks. I mean, they see the Sea Lions ball. Great thing again there is they went down low, so hands straight up and went down. They went down to get it. So not jumping at it, not using their body, just being straight up. Okay, defensive move there.
Kanisha checking back in for the Nighthawks. Checking back in the Sea Lions. Number 10, Allie. Yeah. Carry on.
These five on the court here are the scoring offense. Our key scorers are here. Oh. It's a great drive. Oh, come on. I don't know if we're not deciding not to get
block
rebounds
out
anymore or box out. I mean, the Sea Lions are absolutely gobbling up offensive rebounds like crazy, and good for them. Like, we're just standing around watching them, not boxing out. And they absolutely, in the last few minutes, why they're what's the we win the rebounding stats
15
are.
15 to 14, they're up by one offensive rebound.
Well, I bet we were hit by a mutt, and they've caught up to us by sure. The last little bit, they've absolutely out-rebounding us, especially offensive rebounds.
44-45 with 7:54 left.
Again, makes this one here, can tie it up.
Quarter with her second shot, up and in.
Pretty shot, nicely done.
Kanishka into Pinson. Pinson brings the ball up far side. Back to Kanishka, to Clark. Ooh, that's a tough pass. Shaughnessy with a drive and a block.
Wow, that was close.
If she would have stood there with her hands up, I think we would have got off.
I think
a charge.
You could have. We got the block, but I could have easily seen that going to the charge. Yeah, the Sea Lions coach doesn't like it, and I'll be honest, I agree with her.
Steve was asking if she was shooting. I don't think she was shooting yet.
I think Steve is happy to get a foul and walk away.
Yeah, I agree.
Just back away there. The beggars can't be choosers a little bit there.
Shaughnessy in the baseline.
Calm down, no comment.
Clark over to Pinson.
We just look a little bit unsure. Our passes aren't getting right there.
Shaughnessy
the
on the drive.
Oh, nice rebound.
Ellie Friend. Oh, to Shaughnessy
come
underneath.
Come on now, come
there
on.
There we go.
Come on now.
Team ball right there.
Boy, great look by extra pass by Cammy.
Ellie Friend also with a pass underneath. Boy,
she is good. Number 25.
Sherratt.
Haley Sherratt, my word. She has got a great body control. She had like 12, 13 points the game so far. Man, she is absolutely shot well inside and outside. Love her game.
Shaughnessy on the drive.
Oh, extra pass.
Out of bounds.
Went off. Almost had it. Almost had that crossover there to go to a left-handed layup. And the Sea Lions player caught up and poked it out. So
18 on the shot clock. Pinson getting ready to inbound the ball to Shaughnessy. On the far side, cut by Clark. Down low to Ellie Friend.
Double teamed. Up around. Oh,
nice
cutter.
Ball. Nice cut.
There it is. Come on.
With Clark and no foul.
Come on,
she
Emma Clark.
Woo!
Nice drive to the hole. It's a price you pay for double team on the block. You got a cutter come down the lane. Nice job again by. Look at this save here.
Great defense.
No. Ah. Sadly, I think that's the right call. I don't like it. She had not established herself. That's the call we just had. It's great. It's a great. Steve's not arguing the call. Oh, it's such a bummer. It's a great steal. The ball had not come to forecourt, and she had not established herself. You got to get her feet in bounds. Get it. Come on, Emma. Wow, Emma is absolutely everywhere. I would hate her guarding me. Good Lord.
O'Neal at the top, drives with the left, back to Turk, gets cut off. Great help by Ellie Friend.
Oh,
Turk
nice.
Spotting up, no.
It's a nice move there. She had a fake, and that's again on defense. What you don't want to do is when they launch up, you can't leave your feet, so she left her wide open for the baseline.
Kate Clark on the drive. Back to Friend at the top.
Oh, Shaughnessy thought
Davis.
About it. A good decision. 18 a shot clock.
Jordy on the drive and the floater. No good. Got her own rebound. Sets it back up. A new 20 seconds on the shot clock.
The offensive rebound by Jordy. Again, really huge offensive rebound there. Set it, reset it up.
Jordy stop and pop. No good. Emma Clark.
Again. Well, again, Emma Clark, again, a couple times,
right,
just showed up. But again,
right place, right time.
She was right the place.
Yes.
She was there. That's the point. If you're right there around the basket, you get it. So, wow.
Folks, we want to remind you, if you want to stay around, the guys will be playing Midwestern State about 7:30. Stay around and listen to Craig Stensgaard and Kerry Cook on the call. And be right after this game. It's 51-49. We'll be back after the timeout. All right, after the timeout, C-Line's getting ready to inbound the ball.
Yeah, Steve Ball timeout so we can get a full court press set up here.
Oh,
the
long
baseball pass.
Pass,
absolutely home run ball. Well done.
To Turk.
Yeah, you always got to watch out for
we
that
got caught.
Play.
Yep.
Got
Shaughnessy
caught.
Davis.
Too many hands in the cookie jar there.
Clark back to Davis on the drive. Wow.
Oh my, what a nice floater. Boy, that was a nice finish there.
I thought she was so far into the basket, there's no way. Great shot by Davis. Turk on a up and under. Over the back, no call. Off the sea lines.
That's a case where they know the play is going to happen. Why bother the foul? Just let it go. It's a case where if they would have recovered it, maybe you call it then, but as a referee, the less calls, the better, I think.
Yeah.
But you got to keep that game in check and in rhythm. Jordan Pence at the top of the key. Kate
Back
Clark
to Clark.
A slip screen.
Down low. No. Oh, there's the foul. On number 12, Madison Corder.
The second foul by Point Loma Sea Lions. This quarter must be a media timeout.
Yep, under five. Media timeout. Your score, Nighthawks 53, Point Loma Sea Lions 51. We'll be back after the timeout. getting to start after the media timeout. Stats seem to be pretty similar through
yeah, field goal percentage. The Sea Lions are doing a little bit better, I think, at 40% versus our 36%. No team is shooting the ball 3 points very well at all, so they need to abandon that. I think both teams are averaging about 11%, which is not good. Inbounding here by Jordan. Clock is going. Kate Clark, back the ball to Jordan, top of the key.
Jordan's looking to get the ball to Castledine and on the drive. Off the glass, no good.
That was a great job by number 10, yeah. Carrion there to kind of shut that drive off and force a tough shot off the glass there.
Nighthawks need to get a stop here to keep the lead at 53-51. Back door.
Yeah, a little aggressive
yeah,
there.
You saw that coming.
Yeah, and they've been pretty successful in our back door so far. I think right now we just settle down. Got our leaders on the floor. I think it's time for Jordan or McKenna or Shaughnessy to do something here.
Clark brings the ball up far side to McKenna.
Oh, nice defense there.
It's
by
a
number
long
24,
pass.
Shayla O'Neill. Well, yeah, it was telegraphed, so yeah. Shayla absolutely saw it. But good job by Shayla there. Let's go and poke her hands in the passing lane. Oof, that was tight in the corner there.
Jordy's setting up the play at the top of the key. Crossover through the legs, back to Friend, down low with a spin move and a call.
Yeah, she had the height. That play was set up because of the height, the switch there. And then number one, Ellie Turk kind of pushed her in the back. That'll be really crucial here for us to make these free throws by Ellie Friend.
Emma Clark checking back in.
Got both Clark sisters, Ellie Friend, Kenna Castledine and Jordan Pinson on the floor for the Nighthawks.
Good knee bend here for you, Brent.
That's a little hard. Ooh, got a shooter's roll.
Shooter's roll.
I like the knee bend, get you that arch. but that bell backspin there, as Jeff Hornacek told us back in the day. Little backspin, knee bend, soft hands, get a soft touch off there. And not so soft that
not,
time.
Not so much on the second.
Both of them were long. She got a better roll in the first one. So
54-51 with 3:50 left in the fourth period. Carry on at the top with the left-hand dribble. The cutter, no look down. Back up top to Turk, excuse me. Long three ball, no good.
Yeah, boy, 45 was there for that rebound, number Annika Thayer.
Yeah, Thayer had a little height advantage over to Jordy Pinson.
Well, nobody was there. I mean, I'm not sure where her defender was, but she was there to set up as well. So it feels like this game is going to be tight to the end, so free throws are absolutely crucial. Nighthawks just 1 for 2. We'll see what Thayer does on this, on her chance here to go for two.
Barry's the first, 52-54. Thayer getting ready for her second. And does not make it. Rebound by Clark. Over to Pinson on the far side. Brings it up to Castledine. Castledine on the far side.
Oh, what a recovery by Emma. Wow, it's a very athletic play. I'm sure you guys can see that online.
Yeah, there's a block foul.
Emma absolutely
saved us.
Saved us there. She absolutely stopped and
she established herself back in and.
Yep.
Point Loma foul number 24. Shayla O'Neill, her third personal, fourth team foul. Jordy Pinson, stop. Outside to Castledine, to Clark. Three-point shot,
oh,
no good.
Man.
Block that, out by Carrion.
Brings the ball up. Three-point shot has absolutely been elusive tonight for the Nighthawks and for the Sea Lions as well. But those shots are open. Keep shooting them. I mean,
keep
this time of the
game,
absolutely. When they're, as long as you're not forcing them, that's a travel.
That's a jump ball. That's a great call.
It's a jump ball or a travel, one of the two. It's a great defense there by the Nighthawks.
Great defense by Jordy.
Those hands in there, pesky hands without reaching is the key.
That's right.
Getting there, that.
Pinson across the half court mark to Clark. Point Loma's getting some aggressive hands. Clark with a left hand dribble, stop and pop, no good. Over the back.
Over the back by Emma Clark. Yep.
A little strong.
Well, it's too bad. She's been great in his little floaters.
Fourth team foul. Ganiska checking back in.
Setting up again for a full court press. Obviously, last time we're going to watch the home run ball they missed last time.
Inbounds to Carry On. Carry On back. Over to Surratt. Surratt left-handed dribble back to Carry On. Cross court. Long three ball. No good. Let it go out of bounds. There we go. Nighthawk basketball. 2:09 left. 54-52. Nighthawks are up.
Well, this is where, of course, the whole game is important, but 2 minutes ago, every possession now is really critical. You want to be smart with the ball. You know, and keep being aggressive. I'm sure he wants to keep being aggressive.
Kanishka, top to Friend, over to Jordy Pinson.
Boy, that block is so wide open. No one's flashing. So surprised. Oh, he's wide open.
Oh.
Oh, oh, this is too bad on lots of levels there. She was wide open. The pass was late. Went off her hands, and then a foul. Go to the line and shoot two. That's really unfortunate. Yeah, that's a tough call there.
Yeah. So they're not going to be shooting because they're going to call it an offensive foul.
Okay, you're right. Call a charge. That's interesting. Call the charge. Okay.
Well, I don't know if it's called a charge. Don't know if there's any possession established.
That's interesting there.
Yeah. But I saw him talking with the coach.
Okay.
The official was talking with the coach and saying there was
54-52.
1:45 left.
Boy, every possession here absolutely crucial.
Turk bringing the ball across the line. Annika with a drive and
nice
a scoop.
Nice scoop. Tie ball game, 54. 90 seconds left.
Steve Steele taking a timeout. Again, just a reminder, as Tim's letting us know, the PA announcer, that we will be the guys will be taking on Midwestern State at 7:30, probably about a half hour after this game. So we look forward for you guys staying around and listen to Kerry Cook and also Craig Stensgaard on the call. We'll see you after the timeout.
All right, game reset. Tied at 54, Nighthawks throwing the ball in. Jordan Pence at the top of the key.
25 seconds on the shot clock. Kanishka with the ball. Looking down low to Eubanks.
Oh, man.
Did not take the shot down low.
She was right there.
Jordy Pence with a three ball. No good. Jordy did not follow her shot. Carry On with the rebound. 1 minute to go in the game. 54-54. Turk with a ball, far side. C-line setting up a play. Turk still has the ball. Down to Annika.
Good great hands by Claire.
But no one went after the ball.
I think everybody's tired. And everyone was really over there. At the case where no one was close to it. Now is 7 seconds on the shot clock here. We got substitution coming in. We got
Emma and Castledine coming back in.
Castledine's long hands. You want to be careful, give her some space there. Active hands.
Got five on the shot
nice
clock.
Nice job by Claire.
Oh, ouch. Oh, that's an offensive foul.
Absolutely. It's great hustle by Claire Eubanks there. Absolutely outworking the Sea Lions player. There'll be no foul shots, offensive foul.
But 41 great seconds left.
It's a huge play late in the game. Now we need the Nighthawks to take advantage of this. They go for the best shot. They'd like to go for a 2-for-1, I imagine, if it's available to them.
Konishki inbound to Pinson. Pinson brings the ball up.
Yeah, they're taking their time. That's a good thing. They take a good shot. Oh, man, again, just.
Eubanks.
Want to be courageous here.
To Jordy Pinson.
We're playing really apprehensive right now.
Jordy's got to dribble the ball. 13 on the shot clock. Konishka with the ball.
Boy, great defense by the Sea Lions.
Nice crossover.
Great block.
Timeout call by the Sea Lions. 11.3 seconds left.
That was a timeout, not a foul, correct?
Correct. Timeout.
Okay, 11 seconds.
They can advance the ball.
They can. Half court.
Yep.
They'll wait for the last shot, obviously. Woo! Well, the tail two halves. Nighthawks absolutely dominated the first half, and the Sea Lions dominated the second
half, especially the third period.
Yeah, we kind of held on. This fourth quarter is coming a draw, I suppose. Both teams just playing hard, but not capitalizing on a lot of offense. But Sea Lions have a chance to get victory. And we'll see now. I'm sure you'll want to. You also know if you have five fouls. You don't really want to foul here at all. You have a good defense, active hands, go for a steal without fouling is going to be key here.
Right. Pressure on the inbound player. I'm sure that will be carry on bringing the ball
in. I'm looking for a little steal by McKenna Castledine or Emma Clark or Jordan here.
Looks like Turk will be bringing the ball in. Usually it's been carry on, but I think Turk's going to try to see if they can get the ball to carry on for a three-point ball.
And they've been so good at the baseline or the block second half.
There it is down below in the back. Turk down low.
Nice job.
Great
steal.
Defense. Timeout. Steve.
Okay, we'll have five. What, great steal again. What did we call it there? Great steal there.
Pressure on the inbound.
Exactly.
And they sunk down on the defense down below. Team defense.
So if I'm a betting person, I'm going to say Jordan Pinson's flying up the court to dish it off for an outside two or three. Or just taking herself all the way for a jump shot. We'll see. 5.6 seconds to go. Great game. Great defensive stop on that end by the Nighthawks.
Do you get the ball in and do you drive and look for the foul?
Well, the refs are going to be hesitant to call a foul at the end of the game unless it's obvious. I mean, they don't want to make it up to them. So the last couple of plays, they've been a lot of contact without calling foul. So
good point.
The refs are going to be hesitant to call it unless it's really flagrant. If it's close, they're not going to call it. That's what you can usually guarantee. But I love a penetration here.
I wish I had my long-range glasses to see what Steve Steele is drawing up here.
I can see what he's drawing up here. I won't tell you. We'll give it away for the team. Well, we'll see if what he draws up, what they do. Obviously, you're going to play what the defense does to you. The key here is to play without fear. You got 5 seconds. Everything's got to be sharp. They poke the ball away, it's not going to work. You've got to have sharp passes, and nothing can go. Nothing extra time can take here. You got to clear an inbound pass, and then go.
And you know the scouting report on the Nighthawks. Protect it and keep it away from Jordy Pinson.
Yeah, well, right now the key here is the inbound pass. This is the whole party right here.
Yep.
Cammy's got to give a nice inbound pass. It's got to receive cleanly.
There's the Jordy. No, that's. That was a block.
Yeah, it was a block. Boy, that's when they maybe could have called. There was a lot of body on that. That's what I said before. The refs are going to hesitate to call the foul at the end. You could have called something there. They're going to talk about it.
Are they going to take a look or not?
I think they're going to look at. Oh, hang on a second. We'll find out.
They are going to look at it.
They're going to look at it. Well, when I saw it live, I told.
I thought it was a clean block, but.
Well, it was a clean block. The key is the body.
Body.
So the key is it was a block, but her body got into her. And I think, if I view this, when I saw it live, again, while they hesitate to call, they're reviewing it right now. They could get you
block
get a
on the shot to come into the yeah. come into the player.
The block was clean. It was just a body shot underneath, and that's where it would not surprise me to get a foul shot of this. Now again, as refs, because they're looking at this, means that that means they get a chance to review in their heads what they saw, because typically they're going to hesitate to call it live. But we'll see. Again, the block was clean, but I think the body, she might have hit the body there. As they do, they'll bring in the third official to review it, to kind of all through, and they'll confer. We're trying to get a replay here for you guys to look at as well. They are conferring in the middle. I think they...
Coaches will be called to the to half court.
Let's see what we got here. I think they're going to call a foul.
I think they are, too. They're explaining that.
Oh. Nope, maybe not. Yep, I ain't no foul.
After further review, we head over to time.
Yeah. Well, again, I think it leans to they're going to hesitate to call the last play of the game. Here we go.
Yeah. Just good. Saw the replay, and it. I don't know if there was enough evidence there to
yeah.
to well, warrant it.
As, again, seeing it live, the shot was a clean block.
Right.
But I was sure the body happened. They're going to jump this year, aren't they?
Yep, we're going to jump ball. 5 minute overtime, 54-54.
Well, in some ways fitting. A great game. We get a little extra bonus coverage here.
And again, important. Five fouls still.
Exactly. So foul shots will be crucial.
Yes.
And watching your. Oh, nice, clean. Boy, and Kate Clark absolutely hustled that down. Boy, the Clarks are so great on hustle plays.
Castledine, top of the key, with a dribble back to Pinson. Jordy, the stop and pop. No good. Rebound, Surratt underneath for the Sea Lions to Turk. Turk will bring it up court. Looking for the screen on Clark, switch, Kanishka. 3-point shot, that's long.
Great rebound.
Jump ball. Jump ball. Possession stay with the Sea Lions.
Number 12, Madison Quarter. She's had several really good, it should be Sea Lions ball. The Nighthawks got the jump there.
Right.
Madison had several key rebounds tonight.
Carry on inbound. Down low to Surratt.
Three. Boy. Choosing the key a long time. They let it go.
Walker on the drive, or excuse me, Castle on the drive. Ooh, Ellie Friend took one in the chops.
And Castledine
with the.
You love to see Castledine make that first layup, but they stayed with it. Good chance to earn now from the stripe.
That's a lot of collision down there.
There was, yeah. You'd like to have made that first layup, but. Stayed with us and did okay. Shaughnessy in for Kanishka.
Checking back in for the Sea Lions, number 45, Annika Thayer.
Coming out was Madison Quarter, who got her fourth foul there. Nice clutch free throw there by McKenna.
56-55, 4:09 left in overtime. Checking on the timeouts.
Boy, nice shots by.
There we go, clutch free throws.
Great free throws, are exactly right, well said.
Full court press by the Nighthawks, Shaughnessy Davis.
Be careful, Shaughnessy, they could have called you there.
Oh, that's an offensive. That's got to
be
an
a
offensive.
Wow, that's a bad call. That was a total travel.
That was either an offensive foul because she pushed her in the back or a travel. And Steve Steele is beside himself.
Yeah, that was, she was out of control on that one. Yeah. The Sea Lions got a gift there, but that's okay. It happens. It goes both ways. But that was clearly a travel. Out of control.
Yeah, out of control. Carry on, makes her first, 57-56, 4 minutes left. Steve still getting his money's worth.
Went over the back there. It's got to
yep.
be.
on Annika Thayer.
We'll shoot him on this end now. Boy, and this is going to be elongated overtime with all the foul shots. But again, the key will be who makes your foul shots. Right now it's 2-for-2 for the Nighthawks, 1-for-2 for Sea Lions. So Kate can knock these down, can push a one-point lead. But no gimmies. Every shot's a big one.
Yeah, every time you're at that free throw line, take advantage of it.
There it is.
First one's in.
No hesitation.
57-57. Clark getting ready for her second shot. Up and in.
Nice
58-57 Nighthawks. 3:59 left in overtime.
Emma coming in for Kate. Sisters high five midcourt stripe.
Turk with the ball.
I will say, I think the Sea Lions did a phenomenal job with our press in the second half.
Yeah, breaking press. Yeah.
They have had very few turnovers to kind of solve that press, so good on them for that adjustment.
Well, that's offensive foul, no?
Good hands again by Kate bothering that. That was a good no call, I think.
Yeah. 9 on the shot clock. Surratt.
Oh, man. I don't know what that foul was.
Was that a 3-point shot as well?
No, that was a 2-pointer. Boy, that's a tough call. I didn't see that foul at all, but refs did. Chance here to go up by 2 for the Sea Lions. It's a great shot. I didn't see the foul. It was kind of a rushed turnaround, but great player, 25.
I'm sure Steve will give a little earful. Pinson across half court to Clark, to Kanishka. Kanishka stop and pop.
Oh,
no
man.
Shot. Surratt with a rebound. Turk with a ball. 3 minutes and 15 seconds left. Point Loma up 60-58. Carry on with the ball. Back to O'Neill. Back to Turk at the top. Down low to Surratt. Steve's calling for 3 seconds. It's a block out. Yep, 45. Yep. Annika Thayer. I think that's her fourth.
I believe so.
Got some fans asking why the officials are taking over overtime with their whistle.
Makes the first one there.
There we go. Lloyd Wade back in the ball game.
That's even Lloyd. I love Lloyd's time in here. It should be short. All right, 1-point game.
59-60.
Oh, my.
Man, they called Clark?
No.
With the armbar?
They called. Oh, they did call that.
They called
wow.
Clark. I can't believe that. That was O'Neill with a forearm shiver. O'Neill at the line shooting 2, 2:48 left. Point Loma up 60-59. Point Loma up. O'Neill getting ready for her second shot. Up and good. 62-59.
Yeah, offensively, the Nighthawks need to find a good rhythm here.
We have time. There's time.
Yeah, there's plenty of time. The key is not to get anxious, but to play smart and play hard. I love penetration. I love getting spotting somebody up for an open jumper. I love
Jordy into Lloyd Wade. Back up to Clark. Over to Castledine. To Pinson. Drives out to Loy. Back to Castledine. Loy's on the floor.
Oh, that's a bad shot.
Yeah, it's a tough shot.
Yeah, that's a fall away hook with an angle. That's a bad shot. They didn't want that one there.
Nope.
All right, play some defense here. Again, we got Sea Lions that handled the Knox pressure really well second half, and including overtime.
Out to carry on, a long shot off of Point Loma. 2:08 left.
3-point differential here.
Pinson bringing the ball up court. Turk with a little bit of defense, not much, just spying
away
with a drive.
Well, that's going to be a foul there.
That's on carry on.
Yeah.
I think that's her fourth. Her third, excuse me.
Karen's had a phenomenal game. Not quite 31 points from yesterday, but dominant player for the Sea Lions tonight.
1:57 left. Point Loma 62, Nighthawks 59. Pinson.
All these free throws are absolutely crucial right now.
Pinson sinks her first. This is where make it, play some great defense, get a turnover, and score.
Yeah. It's going to be long. Good rebound by McKenna. Wow. And they're calling both ways, but a lot of fouls being called. Like every time there's a body hitting the floor, they're calling a foul. It's gone both ways. That one, boy. Again, the key here, you got fortunate. You got a rebound, offensive rebound, and a foul shot. So Kenna's got to hit these.
First one's up and good, 61-62.
Now the chance to tie this game.
Castledine getting ready. For her second,
nice
up and
job.
Good. 62-62.
Okay, key is good defense here. Key is not fouling. Good defense without any fouling.
Carry on bringing the ball up with a push off.
Yeah, that's close both ways there.
Yeah. Turk with the ball on the near side.
It's a moving screen.
Down
there.
Low.
That's a foul.
Yep, Loy's out. Yeah. That was a moving screen. Good.
Yeah, it was a moving screen. I don't think there's a lot of body contact there. But Loy got beaten, so she had to go and just a smart play. Make her earn from the stripe. He's going for an easy layup there.
At the line for the Sea Lions, number 12, Madison Corder.
That is Loy's fifth. Loy had a good game. Boy, I like Loy's game. Started tonight.
Got the shooter's roll there. Corder did. 63-62, 1:42 left. Second one up and good. Corder makes both. 64-62. Pinson bringing the ball up. Cross half court to Clark.
Good.
Back to her sister. Back to Jordan. Jordan with a stop and pop. And a great bucket.
That was so pretty.
Wow.
We haven't seen that since the first quarter. Tie ball game, 120 to go.
Back to carry on to Turk.
This is coming down to
top.
Good
back
defense.
To carry on.
Good
back
defense
to Surratt.
And rebounds, Rob, will be the key the next few minutes, next minute here.
Turk with a left-hand dribble. Jordy cuts her off.
She's going to come back around. Good job by Jordy. Wow, that's a great shot. Jordy had great D, and it's a better shot.
Needs a little backside help on the on the defense.
Did. Yeah, she didn't have any help there.
Under 1 minute to play, 53 seconds to go. Jordan Pinson with the ball.
Boy, Jordan looks tired.
Out to McKenna, no good. Rebound.
Claire Eubanks, oh, we got a foul. And that's her fifth on number 12, I believe. Madison Corder. Madison had a great game.
That's her fifth.
Madison had some key parts of this game. So it's a big rebounds and great shots down below.
Checking back in for the Sea Lions, Annika Thayer.
Well, again, free throws are absolutely crucial here. Claire's got to knock these down. 41 seconds left.
Deep breath. Nice, easy stroke. Nope. All right, Claire, get set. Here we go.
Got one shot left.
Second one up and good.
Okay, got a timeout by the Sea Lions. 1 point game.
And they will advance the ball.
41
to half
seconds
court.
To go.
There's still time.
Well, yeah, I mean, so obviously they'll have to shoot. They'll probably will held as long as they can. to be a case for great defense. Go for a steal if you can. Not, you don't want to foul if you don't have to, obviously. But you want to be aggressive.
Yeah.
I think the key is make him shoot an outside shot.
I think so.
I don't have them go inside at all. I want to keep that as possible. Push him outside.
I think it's going to be that game between Turk and Carry On.
Yeah.
And even Surratt. Well, Surratt, you know, they could get Surratt down in the paint as well.
That's what they want to do, because you're closer and often you get more fouls down there. So, but we'll see if we can sneak a Nighthawk steal here, what we're so good for, long hands. Maybe McKenna can get in the lane here. Got the Clark sisters, who are feisty and do not let anything come easy. So, key is good footwork here and active hands, and try to get a stop.
All right. 41.3 seconds left. Denial right there with Clark.
Oh, great defense.
Timeout.
Woo, great defense by Kate Clark there.
I thought.
Thought you got her hooked a little bit.
I thought hook, and it didn't get called, but that was tough defense by Niagara. You can't deny the tough defense.
I'm with you. You probably could have called a foul there. It was just great defensive play. So, again, down by 1 point. The question is, how early do you want to shoot this ball? You want the best shot you can have.
Only 5 seconds came off the clock, so.
Yeah. Well, you're not worried about a 2-for-1 here because
you
want the best shot you can get. Boy, you'd love to see him go inside again. You just don't want to, we've been selling for these kind of fadeaway floaters, and those, the odds there have been tough. You want a straight-up clean shot. Even a shot in the three, in the corner, if it's open, I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
You just don't want a running jumper that's got to go off the glass.
No.
I think our shot selection, we settled for some tougher shots second half. It's made it challenging.
Yeah, you got Thayer, who's 6'1", is going to be covering the paint. And also O'Neill, who's 6 foot. They'll be controlling that paint.
Want to give a shout out to my former professor, Dr. Michael Lodahl, who's listening in from beloved professor at Point Loma, who's professor here for a good stretch. And so go for it, Mike. I love you, but I hope the Sea Lions don't win tonight. Is that fair?
Good. It's fair.
37 seconds left to go. Jordan on the inbound, takes the ball in. We'll see if we can make something happen here.
Jordy guarded by Turk.
They're going to hold clear out. Doing a screen up top here. Jordan's trying to get a hold to the hole.
Left-handed drive.
Oh, tough shot.
It's a tough shot.
Boy, I can't think that was a shot Steve wanted. You know Jordan has the ball, is great. But that shot, again, was going away from her, a floater with a bank on the way. Just a tough shot for her to try to make. But when it's, again, 22 seconds, and the reality is you're going to probably have to foul if they don't, because you're down the one shot, the 1 point here. So at some point you have to foul. I imagine they'll go for a steal and see how that goes and then just kind of play it out. But that last shot is not what they want, I don't think.
To foul early.
I don't know that you'd foul early. I think you'd go for a steal and take your chances. If you do foul, obviously, the worst-case scenario, you're down by three. But I would say you're not going to foul. You want to make them pass a couple times, go for some steals. I would say with 10 seconds, if they still have the ball, you want to foul then, because you want enough time to set up a three-point shot and see what happens from there.
Yeah. I was just looking at who Point Loma will have probably in. And if you do foul, I'd foul Thayer. She is at about 55%. And then O'Neill's at 44% on the free throw.
Yeah, well, that could be one of the strategy too. Kind of foul somebody who isn't that great free throw shooter. So you think 45. When they're doing an inbound here. Yeah. So again, they don't even bother to cover. Well, I'm curious here, the play here. They're spreading out the Nighthawks for the full court here. They're wanting to get a bucket down low. We'll see where they go here.
That's a person you don't want to foul.
Well, Steve was calling foul right away, so I think they didn't care. And I think they had their two worst foul shooters on the other end. That was the goal. Don't foul us.
Yeah.
So here, worst case scenario, well, a lot of worst case scenarios, but they make both of these, you're down by three with 20 seconds to go. Obviously, She's shooting two, so she can miss both would be great. But she's a great shooter, so we'll see how this goes. There was no hesitation there, was there?
No.
That was up and in.
Confident shooter.
Yep. Yeah, again, it's usually the one you don't want to shoot. That's in as well. All right, down three. Plenty of time.
Pinson brings the ball up court. Crossover stop and pop for three. She got fouled.
Oh, wow. Wow. The one thing their coach did not want to have happen, she's shooting three. She's got to make them. Now, I will say Point Loma has 14 seconds, but Jordan's going to have to knock all these three down. I did not see. Oh, and we that's the last one for 45. It's her fifth.
Thayer is out with five fouls. Checking back in for Point Loma is number 13, Maddie Mersch.
Well, all free throws are big. These are really big free throws. First one in. Need two more.
Jordy up and in for her second.
Okay, one more. Now they have 14 seconds left. Obviously, Point Loma's done a really good job in their half-court offense. See if Jordy can make this last one to tie this game up.
Up and good.
It looks yes.
That's clutch basketball by that young lady.
That is
clutch basketball.
The last one got some rim action there, but got it in. Well, whoo, Rob, 14 seconds.
68-68.
What a great game.
It's a great game. Fantastic game.
Both teams playing so hard. Nighthawks dominated the first half. Sea Lions dominated the third. And really, the Nighthawks did not look comfortable the whole second half.
No.
And really, I think the Sea Lions have played a better game the second half by far. We hung around, to be honest with you. I think we were fortunate to be in this position. So we'll see the approach here with 14 seconds to go. Obviously, Nighthawks have had some success stealing the ball. The key is doing that without fouling, because you don't want to foul at all. And again, you want to keep them outside. Shooting outside shots, the goal.
Yeah, taking a look at Point Loma, their two bigs are out.
Right. So again, and they've hurt this tonight down low. So again, as I said before, the refs aren't going to want to call a foul on a shot unless it's blatant. But they typically call more down low than outside. So
Point Loma is out of timeouts as well. Nighthawks have one timeout left. They will advance the ball to half court. Steve was hoping that was a mistake, but it was not. Turk on the inbound.
I would say just watch Sarret. Sarret is so good down low. You don't want to have her getting the ball down low. Oh.
Blocked by Jordy. Jordy should have just stayed.
She's got to stay there. It's absolutely a block. I don't know why she didn't flop and come down. She could have not been falling over there. It's a block all day.
Yeah.
I thought Sarret going to the baseline. What'd I tell you? Yeah. That was an absolute foul. And Jordy's got to just stand there. She falls down, it's a charge.
Yeah. That's not. Oh, how did that stay in?
Wow. That was fortunate.
Alter call for Sarret tomorrow with that shot. All right, 11.3 seconds left. Nighthawks.
Buddy.
Call a timeout and advance the ball at half court. 70-68.
11 seconds to go. Again, I think you want, I like McKenna driving here. Is Shaughnessy been in a while? She's been out.
She has not.
Yeah, I think they have the Clark sisters in there. And Claire, looks like. So we'll see. 2 points, boy. Sea Lions, I saw that opening there, and Sarret has been so good down there. I thought, man.
Yeah, the spin move. Yep.
And Jordan was there. She's got to stand firm and fall down.
Yep.
I think she goes down. It's a charge. But she moved with it, and not going down. She got that block, which it was.
All right, some magic Steve Steele play calling right here.
All right, we got plenty of time. We had a tough time getting good shots, I will say, Rob. But I do think Jordan wants the ball here. Or Kate Clark. Or Emma Clark with an open shot. They've been great too tonight. Open looks. Got to get it in.
There it is to Jordy.
Oh, she lost off her hip. Ah, she lost off her hip.
I think she was trying to get the ball over in the deep corner.
Yeah,
for a three shot, for a three ball.
It's only her second foul. Wow. Yeah, it's too bad. I will say Jordan's been so great. Just a little tired on that last couple minutes. I think it's asking a lot of her. She's obviously your leader. Okay, well,
this is the first.
So, again, the worst-case scenario is you have a three-point lead. But, again, also, you got to get the rebound. If it doesn't make it in.
You don't have any timeouts.
The rebound is crucial. Okay, you got three.
Magic can happen right here. We got a foul on Point Loma.
Yeah, it was a
but
charge.
But it wasn't on the, it
on
wasn't
the shot.
The shooter.
So we set a screen and she bowled through her. So what happened there is we took the shot. The foul's on the shooter. It won't be three shots.
No. Nope.
But she set a screen and blew right through her. So that will be two shots. Now, there's going to be no time. So the summer guard's not going to matter. They might put 0.1 seconds on there. But that's, again, I mean, it's a tough call because, you know, I saw the screen coming. And it was a good screen, but with the call of charge there, it was a tough call. But they're going to review it to see. But right there.
There it is right here.
Yeah.
Clearly, she blew through that.
Clearly a charge there. Now, good replay there for us to look at. So this is pretty much a Point Loma victory at this juncture. If we get two foul shots.
Yeah, no time on the clock. It's probably
0.1 seconds. What you could do is you'd shoot one and do a play where you bounce it off the rim and hope for a putback. But that's, even beyond miracles, it's going to be tough. They're reviewing it. Boy, what a great game.
Fantastic ball game. 68-71.
Yeah, again, on that replay there, it's clearly a blocking call through that screen. She bowled right through it.
I think what they're looking at is see if there's any time left on the clock.
Yeah, that could be it, to be honest. Because technically, I mean, I don't know how that works. Because technically, you count the shot still, if it's the time of the shot, because, I mean, the foul, I mean, if it's a bang-bang play.
Yeah, you would have.
I mean, for example, they're not going to take the shot away
if
it went in. But, I mean, then you got to count the whole thing of the missed shot. So I can't imagine there's more than a 0.1, maybe a 0.2 maybe left.
And there's,
they're still in consultation here.
Well, they have to have people line up. But if there's no time by the clock. You know, 1 second, can you get the tip in if there's
I don't know the ruling here. I don't know the ruling is if you're just extending the game for two shots and that's it. So it's kind of like, you know, at the half sometimes.
Yeah.
You'd shoot foul shots and the time's expired. That could be the call. There are going to be two shots, but there's no time left. So there's point 0.2 seconds left on the clock. I see it.
1 second.
Not a whole second, I don't think. Yeah.
Well, two shots.
0.9 is quite a bit.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the miracle play is this. You make the first shot, and then you have probably a high shot off the rim. You got to tip back in.
Eubanks at the line.
And if she misses the first one, none of it matters.
So what happens if we go, if she misses the second?
You can tip it back in.
Right, but if we get, I guess the question is, do you miss the second on purpose?
Yeah, absolutely.
Go for the rebound and hope for a foul.
You miss it. You're going to miss it on purpose here, and you go for the a good idea. What you want to do?
Yeah, Steve was hoping for a foul, but Kenny got put on the floor.
Yeah, I think that was.
He said, what do you want me to do for you?
Yeah.
He's asking for the block out and the foul, but Steve won't get that call. What a fantastic ball game tonight. Point Loma Sea Lions 71, Nighthawks 69. It's a great weekend for basketball, folks. Stick around for the guys. Northwest Nazarene University men will be taking on Midwestern State in about a half hour. And Steve Steele will regroup and get ready for some GNAC play.
Yep. Well, we had some good preseason games. GNAC's a tough conference. So we will finish some things up. Some people come back from injury, and then we'll give it a go for GNAC. GNAC will be, every game's going to be hard, so we'll give it our best. Tough loss tonight. They certainly well within hand. They just let the Sea Lions back in the game. And Sea Lions outplayed them for the second half and really in the overtime as well.
Tale of two halves.
It really was, yeah.
Yep. Tale of two halves. And I know Steve will be looking at the tape and taking a look to see what they need to do to correct that. Again, thanks for joining us. I'm Rob Donahue along with Brent Peterson. Have a great night. And if you can, stay around. Nighthawk men will be taking on Midwestern State in about a half hour.